Welcome to Trader Made. In this tutorial, you will learn how to use our query generator. You can use the API query URL to run your programs and applications. So, let's get started. Initially, you will need to sign in using your credentials. As you log in and reach your dashboard, you can see an API key exclusively generated for you. From the dashboard, you can navigate to our documentation page. On this page, you will find the query generator option on your left side menu. Now we will go through some examples to see how the query generator works. As you log in with your credentials, you can see the API query URL pre-populated with your API key. And you can also see the API key displayed here. So to start with, let us take an example of our live endpoint, get real-time currency data. Please choose the live option from the drop-down. You can enter multiple currency pairs here. I am selecting USD Euro, Japanese Yen Dollar, and Euro Aussie. As you click on this Run Query button, you will see the bid, ask, and mid prices for the currency pairs requested. So this way you can get the real-time prices for the desired currency pairs. You can use this request URL and simply copy this and use it wherever you want to run your programs and applications. Let's move on to the next example. You can get a tick historical sample using our query generator. Please go through the documentation details for this particular API endpoint to understand what are the limits and what history is available for you. So for tick historical rates, we cover 50 plus currency pairs and there are some limits to the duration of the tick data. If you want tick data for 60 minutes for up to 30 days, you need to subscribe to our advanced plan. You get a tick data sample only for 30 minutes, up to the last 5 working days, not including today. Let's take a look at how we can get a tick historical sample. You need to select the tick historical sample option from the drop-down. You can select one currency pair at a time. For this example, I am selecting the US dollar Swiss franc currency pair, 6th of July 9 a.m. as the start date. Remember, the end date and the time should be within 30 minutes of the start time. You will select the same date, and the end time will be 9:30 a.m. in parameter 3. In parameter 4, you need to select JSON. After entering these parameters, when you click on this Run Query, you get a tick historical sample for US dollar to Swiss francs currency pair. As you can see, there is a lot of data. That's why the sample has been restricted to only 30 minutes. Let's take a look at how we can obtain historical data for various financial instruments using the query generator. First, select historical endpoint, then, in parameter 1 for currencies, you can select multiple currency pairs. For this example, I am selecting pound sterling Chinese yuan, US dollar Turkish lira, and euro GBP. Select any date in the past including today. I am selecting 7th of July here. Click the Run Query, and you will get end of day open high low close prices for the selected currency pairs for the chosen date. Similarly, you can obtain historical data for CFD instruments. Selecting UK oil, that is Brent crude. And, as you click the Run Query, you can see the end of day OHLC prices for UK oil as a result. Again, you can get historical cryptocurrency prices against a fiat currency. For this example, I am choosing Bitcoin US dollar. As As you click the Run Query, you get the end of day OHLC prices for Bitcoin US dollars. Finally, let us take a look at how we can get time series data using our query generator. Before we move further, let us take a look at time series documentation to understand the limitations to obtain data. Daily history is available for 15 years. However, in one call, you can get data for only 1 year. Hourly history is available for 12 months, but you get only 1 month of data per call. Similarly, minute history is available for 1 month. However, in one call, you get data for only 2 days. You need to consider these limitations while entering parameters in the query generator. Let's go back to the query generator. We'll select time series. To start, in parameter 1, select Euro US dollar. In parameter 2 for the start date, I'm choosing the 29th of June as my start date, and in parameter 3 for the end date, I'm choosing 6th of July. In parameter 4 for the format, select records. Parameter 5 for interval, I'm choosing hourly. For the last parameter, parameter 6 for the period, I'm choosing 4. As you enter these parameters and click the Run Query, you get 4-hour data for Euro US dollar within the dates you have selected. If you have any further questions, you can contact our market data experts via email or live chat. Our experts will be happy to help you. Please like, subscribe, and share our videos. Thank you for watching the tutorial.